very thorough manner. Come, let us move into our revision for NEET test. As our 7th is concerned, for your NEET exam, the same portions what we had for our theory only we are going to have. What are the portions? Unit 2 and Unit 3. Unit 2 what we had, 3 chapters we had. And Unit 3 what we had, come on, solid and fluid mechanics, mechanics of solids and fluids, right? So all the contents you have to be very thorough, but in particular, what are the main areas you have to concentrate. So that is what I have written here. So first finish up or learn the full in advance, what I have given in your notes, right? So like the crosswords for every chapters and every video, I have given some set of full in advance. First get that thorough. So you will get 15 marks for physics and 15 marks for chemistry and 20 for biology, right? So in that 15, nearly 7 to 8 questions you will get from that in the class. But, right? Don't think that it will be as easy to answer those questions. I had set one twist in every questions. So I will explain about that, right? Okay, then we have to concentrate on the sums what we have done. We have done numerous sums, especially for 7th standard, so many sums I have done, right? So practice all those sums, very simple sums only we have done, right? But practice it, right? Your practice only will bring you more perfection, right? So what are the formulas, how we have to work out? But when you have to work it out the sum, regarding this NEET test, no need to, as you go in detail for your theory test, don't go in that much depth. But we have to know about the formula, how you have to substitute, how you have to get to the final answer. Not by keeping from each other, by working out the sums. Okay? Right. Next one, formulas, what we are going to learn. All the formulas included in the lesson, you have to verify. Okay? And form of units for every quantities. And the certain laws, you have some laws in the lessons, no? For that class, what are the equations? Based on that equation, sums can be asked, but that equations itself can also be asked. So you have to very thorough with it. Some constant values, along with that, these three equations of motions we learned, no? Forces, V is equal to U plus AT, S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So that the three equations in forces, all those equations, you need to be very clear, right? Now, first, what are the some concepts, some tips I want to give you to that you concentrate first. First, I told you, I have kept from this here, right? So, all the full in advance you are going to learn. So, as you cannot think that it is just memorizing. If I memorize the answer, however, I can answer it very clearly. No. Only when you are very clear with your answer, you can straighten it with the correct answers. But if you have a little confusion, the choices will be given in such a way that it may even create your correct answer in the mind to go wrong. Right? So very clear. So the choices will be in a confusing way. For example, I'll give you a choice afterwards, right? So now, when you are doing sums, and as I told you, you have to be very crisp. To the point you have to explain, no need to explain all the steps. Single steps. Even your mental calculation itself is very good. It is more appropriate than the writing calculations, right? So you have to be that much faster, right? So now powers, sign, decimals. So all these, this is what I have told you when you are seeing a number. For example, I have these answers. Example of each. We have small g value to be 9.8 meter per second square. No. So, and this is... this is one number, it is called as universal gravitational constant. If you would have learned this in your 6th standard, this number, right? So if this number is given in your question paper, first you have to be very clear with the numbers, 6.67. It will be given like that, 7.67, 6.67, 6.76, like that it will be confusing. So first numbers you have to be very clear. Then power, whether it is 10 power minus 11 or plus 11, I'll be very clear. Whether it is 11 or 19, one number already, one another constant is there which will have power 19. So you cannot confuse with that. And second one is this unit, Newton meter square per kilogram square. This two will not have minus. This two will have minus. One way the choices will be kilogram will come here, meter square will come here. So that is how the choices will be made. Very confusing. So you have to be very clear in your choices. Okay. Then so that is what I have told you. Power signs, decimals I will explain here. When this 6.67 is given here, where this decimal point is given, right? After two decimals or three decimals, that and all you need to be very clear, right? So sometimes this answer 1/4 you will get the answer, but 1/4 won't be given in the choice, right? It will be given like 0.25. So like this, one correct answer will be given in another format. So immediately you should not get tense. Immediately raise your hand. Correct answer is not given. Check all the options. Okay. So then you have another choice. No, this choice, can you have you ever seen this? Both of the above, none of the above, all the above, all those and all. If it is coming, then it is a greater check for you. If it is both of the above, means check both the choices above. Right? Then only you should check that. Some people, what they will do? When if they see the correct answer, immediately they will go with the answer. They won't check other options. But if both of the above or all the above or none of the above is given, you have to be very, very careful. Okay, don't think that if both of the above is there, that will be the answer. So sometimes it will also be, it will be also wrong. Okay, so we'll be very clear with it. Right, now come to the main part, formulas and units. So I have simultaneously tabulated here. Right, so velocity is equal to displacement by time, speed is equal to distance by time. Right, so here speed is capital S, displacement is small s. So to differentiate it only, I have written like this. Right, so simultaneously I have tabulated the units here. For velocity, speed, unit is meter per second. See children, how am I reading? I have written in shorter forms, but when I am reading it in the full form. So be very clear with it. Okay, don't read ms power minus 1. It may be correct, but it is not the proper way. Right, right. Next one, acceleration is equal to velocity by time. Right, acceleration unit is meter per second square, time unit is meter, velocity unit already we have written, which is meter per second. F is equal to ma. This is your Newton's second law equation, where mass m is mass, is unit is kilogram, acceleration unit already we have written, F unit is mass, force is, what is the unit for force? It is Newton. I have not written here to the kindly added, force unit is Newton, right? Then impulse we have J is equal to F into T, right? So what is the unit for impulse? It is Newton second. From the formula itself we can straightly write it. Force unit is Newton, time unit is second. So if you know this formula, you can easily arrive at your units. Then we have stress is equal to F by A. Similarly, pressure is also equal to F by A. Right? So what is the unit? Stress, force unit is Newton, area unit is meter square. As it is in the denominator, you have to write minus. Right, so all those things I have explained in the normal classes. Right, so stress and pressure have the same unit. What is the unit? Newton per meter square. And area we have the unit as meter square, and pressure we have another unit Pascal, which we will start with small letter, and in short form it is capital P and small a, Pascal. Okay, now we have some other formulas for pressure. P is equal to h rho g. And this formula we have already learned, P is equal to F by A. Both formulas are same, which will give you the pressure. Well, how will you read this? H, rho, g. H is the height, which will have the unit meter. Rho is the density, which will have the unit kilogram per meter cube. Okay, and g already we have written, it is meter per second square. For acceleration, we have written now. So g is what? What is g? It is acceleration due to gravity. So it is also an acceleration. So it will have the unit meter per second square, right? And we have three equations of motion. All those units. V is equal to u plus at. S is equal to ut plus half a t square, v square is equal to u square plus 2ax. In these three equations, what are all the terms involved? All those units will be here. Right? So that you have to practice. And this is relative viscosity. Rv I have written. So relative viscosity is equal to eta subscripted. Down we have to write. Down that eta L by eta water. Eta of water. What is that eta? N you have to write in an elongated way. I have told you already. So eta of L. L means liquid and eta of water. Where eta is viscosity. That viscosity unit is Newton second per meter square, or it is otherwise called as decapoise. It is also otherwise called as one Poiseuille. So that I have written here once again, I will read it. Okay. What is this? H rho g. Rho is density. Density unit is kilogram per meter cube. Okay. Right. So with this, this for the viscosity children, I have written the unit as Newton second per meter square or decapoise. But what about the units for relative viscosity? Relative viscosity will not have any unit, but viscosity will have unit. Relative viscosity only will not have any unit. Why? Because relative viscosity is eta by eta. So both are similar quantities. Ratio of similar quantities, so they will get cancelled. Okay, that's why relative viscosity will not have any unit. Okay, now come to the next one. Some laws we have. With that laws, we have some equations. What are they? Newton's second law equation is F is equal to ma. Here itself I have told. Right? So then third law will say Fa is equal to minus Fb. Right? So that is not a formula, but it is the equation. Right? Then law of conservation of momentum. I have written in a short form. Dot I have written, it is conservation of small p is momentum, which is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. That is initial momentum. This combined will give you initial momentum, and this combined will give you final momentum. Initial momentum is equal to final momentum. What law is that? Law of conservation of momentum. And we have in solid and fluid mechanics, we have one law, Hooke's law. What is that Hooke's law equation? Stress by strain is equal to a constant. That constant is denoted by the letter E, capital E, and it is called as modulus of elasticity. Right? Next. And we have one other law also, Pascal's law. Do you remember, children? We have that law, but equation as if now no need. Okay? So know these laws and equations. Now we have some constants, number based resonances that I have given here. What is the value of small g? Where and all you will get small g? In that equations of motion we will have, and in this pressure formula we have. Right? So all those formulas we have g. G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. In some sums, children, it won't be given. Most of the sums it won't be given in the question. You have to know it on your own. But in some sums, purposefully it will be given as 10 meter per second square. If the value is given in the question, use that particular value itself, whatever is given in the question paper. Okay. If the value is not given means, then go with this. G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square, but you cannot demand that value must be given in the question paper. It is meant for you to know. Okay, next. This is what I told you already, right? One decapoise is equal to 10 poise, which is equal to 1 Poiseuille. So very, very important relationship. Without confusion, understand it. Okay, then what is the range of interatomic forces? 10 power minus 10 meter, and intermolecular force will have a range of 10 power minus 9 meter. Okay, children, so I have given a wholesome idea how we are going to learn. So pass this video and note down these formulas and units. With these values, you can create miracles in physics and sums in physics, right? So practice well, get good marks. Thank you, children.